Hi everyone, Steve here from Photoshop Essentials. In this video, I show you how to add falling snow to your winter photos in Photoshop. I'm using Photoshop 2023, but any recent version will work. If you're using an older version, like CS6, you'll want the original version of this tutorial, which I've linked to in the description. I'll use this image from Adobe Stock. In the Layers panel, we see the image on the background layer. We need to add a new blank layer above the image, so click the Add New Layer icon at the bottom. Then double-click on the layer's name and rename it Snow. Press Enter or Return on a Mac to accept it. Next, we need to fill this new layer with black, so go up to the Edit menu and choose Fill. In the Fill dialog box, set the contents to black, and then click OK. To create the snow, we'll start by adding some noise to the layer. Go up to the Filter menu, choose Noise, and then Add Noise. In the dialog box, make sure Gaussian and Monochromatic are selected. Then set the amount to around 25% and click OK. And Photoshop fills the layer with noise, which will eventually become our falling snow. But one problem is that the noise is too small. So let's scale it by going up to the Edit menu, choosing Transform, and then Scale. In the Options bar, make sure the link icon between the Width and Height fields is selected. Then change either the width or the height to 400%. Click the check mark to accept it, and now the noise is starting to look more like snow. Back in the Layers panel, make sure the snow layer is selected. We're going to apply a few filters to the noise, but before we do, let's convert the snow layer into a smart object. That way, the filters will be applied as smart filters, which will keep their settings editable. To do that, click the Layers panel menu icon and choose Convert to Smart Object. A smart object icon appears in the lower right of the thumbnail. To blend the noise in with the image, change the blend mode of the smart object from Normal to Screen. Screen hides the black areas on the layer and leaves only the white noise visible. Then to make the snow look like it's falling, go up to the Filter menu, choose Blur, and then Motion Blur. In the dialog box, set the angle to the direction you want the snow to be falling from. You can change the angle by rotating the dial, or you can enter a specific value. I'll set the angle to negative 65 degrees. Distance controls how much motion is applied, but if we increase the distance too much, the effect looks more like rain than snow. So lower values work better. I'll set it to 10 pixels. Then click OK to close the dialog box. Since we applied motion blur to a smart object, we see the motion blur filter listed as a smart filter below the layer. You can double-click on the filter's name to reopen its dialog box and try different settings, but I'll click Cancel to close it. Also notice that Photoshop added a layer mask, or in this case, a filter mask, for the smart filters, which is that big white thumbnail. We could use the mask to hide the filters from different parts of the image, but for this effect, we don't need it. So let's remove it and free up the space by right-clicking or control-clicking on a Mac on the thumbnail and choosing Delete Filter Mask. To reduce the amount of snow and brighten the snow at the same time, go up to the Image menu, down to Adjustments, and choose Levels. Then to reduce the number of snowflakes, click on the black point slider below the left side of the histogram and begin dragging it to the right. As you drag, you'll see the darker snowflakes begin to disappear, leaving only the brighter flakes visible. I'll set the value to around 25. Then to brighten the remaining snow, click on the white point slider and drag it to the left. When you're done, click OK to close the dialog box. Notice that even though Levels is an image adjustment, not a filter, it still appears as a smart filter below the layer. And that's because we applied it to a smart object. So you could double-click on its name to reopen the dialog box and make whatever adjustments you need. I'll move the black point slider a bit more to the right. Then I'll click OK. At this point, we have our initial snow effect. But let's add some depth to it by adding a second snow layer, this time with larger flakes, so they'll look like they were closer to the camera. In the Layers panel, make a copy of the snow layer by dragging it down onto the Add New Layer icon. The copy appears above the original, along with a copy of our smart filters, so we don't need to reapply them. Let's rotate the copy so the new flakes are not just sitting on top of the originals by going up to the Edit menu, down to Transform, and choosing Rotate 180 degrees. Then to make the new flakes larger than the originals, go up to the Filter menu, down to Pixelate, and choose Crystallize. Increase the cell size at the bottom to somewhere between 10 and 20. I'll go with 15. Then click OK to close the dialog box. Again, in the Layers panel, the Crystallize filter is listed as a new smart filter. So if you need to, you can double-click on it to reopen the dialog box and try a different size. But I'll just click Cancel. The only problem with the larger flakes is that they don't have any motion applied to them. So go back to the Filter menu, back to Blur, and once again choose Motion Blur. Leave the angle the same as before so the snow is falling in the same direction. But because these flakes are bigger, increase the distance to around 20 pixels. Then click OK. Finally, let's adjust the amount of these larger flakes by adding one more Levels adjustment. Go back to the Image menu, back to Adjustments, and choose Levels. Then, just like we did before, drag the black point slider to the right to reduce the number of flakes, and drag the white point slider to the left to brighten the ones that remain. Then click OK. And there we have it. I'll click the small arrows in the Layers panel to hide the list of smart filters, then I'll turn off the two snow layers by clicking their visibility icons. So here's the original image, here's our main snow effect, and here's the final result with some larger snowflakes added in. And that's how to add falling snow to your image with Photoshop. Be sure to check out these other videos that use the same steps we learned here to create other effects, like adding stars to a night sky or adding rain to your image. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you in the next video. I'm Steve Patterson from Photoshop Essentials.